It all started 4 years back when we decided to submit a proposal to the European Union on making a documentary and a website on international development cooperation across the world. And lo and behold, to our surprise, the project was approved by the European Union. So now we had to implement all that we had promised to do in our proposal. And this task surely wasn't going to be an easy one.
Employment Guarantee Act is an act that gives people a right to being employed on local public works within 15 days. And I think it could really have wonderful effects, not just in terms of providing security. I mean, the first objective, of course, is to provide some kind of social security to people. But it can also bring about a lot of very interesting social, economic and political change.
Vengo de una transformación de mi propia vida. Yo consumía drogas, hacía parte de una esquina, era delincuente. Tenía malos hábitos en la casa, en la calle. Y realmente no era yo el único, sino también muchos parceros que lo viven a diario también, que tienen muchos problemas, circunstancias. Y estos barrios por lo regular siempre son territorios baldíos por personas que no tienen economía, sino que se agrupan en estos pequeños terrenos. Por eso es que se genera tanta delincuencia.
Entonces, nosotros vamos a las calles con un equipo de búsqueda activa todas las mañanas, 5 de la mañana. Les hacemos sensibilización. Los recogemos de la calle, de las ollas, los puentes, los cambuches. Y los tres hogares cada tiene un equipo dividido en cada uno de los sitios de Bogotá.
Tome, chino. ¿Joder o no? ¿Cómo le ha ido?
Bien.
¿Cuánto lleva en la calle usted, mijo?
Poquito.
¿Sí? ¿Y ahí a los hogares de paso? Acá al patio de Ipro. Ah, bueno, ya tomé. Recuerde que hay otras posibilidades diferentes a la calle y que estamos para atenderlos, ¿me entiende? Todo bien.
Of course, after 4 years, it will not be the end of it. But we feel that once the program will be over after 4 years, that the communities and the leaders within the communities, they will be on a higher level of development.
As we were learning more and more about the Millennium Development Goals, a new question was entering our agenda and was forcefully stealing the show. How is it that Millennium Development Goals are so little known? Why does the main media not cover what governments are doing to improve the lives of hundreds of millions of persons? Why do international institutions find it so difficult to tell journalists what they're doing for reducing extreme poverty and social exclusion?
The neglect of basic education and schooling was unforgivable. And it took the civil society movement, the right to education movement, years of pushing and pushing and pushing until it was made a fundamental right in the middle of, in 2003.
These were images of children in Syria in 2011. Since the start of the civil war in 2012, hundreds of children have been killed in Syria. Thousands have been displaced, and hundreds of thousands have had their relatives killed, wounded, arrested, deported, and these numbers are increasing every day. Perhaps it should be compulsory for decision makers, before they take on any form of leadership, to first be school teachers. Perhaps only then would they acquire that humaneness that is needed for being authentic and trusted community leaders. Because liberation is always a blossoming of enabled personalities. Instead, imposition of whatsoever value and norm does not liberate anyone. And violence brutalizes the souls of all.
If you look at a long period of time, social issues have a deep impact on business, very, very deep impact on business. And therefore, that's an issue that is as much a part of business sustainability, and therefore all business people must be involved with it. And we realized, we have now sort of got convinced over the past 10 years, that education has the greatest multiplier effect. And it's the same old story. You know, if you give somebody a fish, you feed him for a day, or feed her for a day. But if you teach somebody to fish, then you've taken care of his or her life.
Those who justify themselves are not believed. While explaining what they do for reducing poverty, organizations tend to be preachy and heartrending. People are mostly untouched by such rhetoric, because after all, humanitarian organizations are only promoting their business niche. What needs to be done is doing away with efforts to convince anybody about anything. One should not aim at creating consensus. One should try to enable informed judgments. One should collect the stories of people working in cooperation projects, record their motivations and the challenges they encounter. These stories can be shared with those who are trusted by the public: journalists, teachers, intellectuals. We can help opinion makers in forming a clearer opinion about cooperation activities. Opinion makers will apply their critical faculty and inform their public on what to think about us. We will receive criticism, but we will have a communication environment that is free of rhetoric. Once there's no rhetoric, we can build trust. Where there is trust, cooperation is possible.
Biggest challenges that we all faced at that point of time was that the men were very suspicious. They did not want the women to get out of their homes. They did not want the women to work. They did not want the women to earn. So there was tremendous resistance from the men. But to the credit of the women, they all ganged up and they said that, no, we want to do this. We have to do this. We want to do this and we're going to go ahead.
The women of this community, women decided to come together, you know, form a group and start, you know, some activities such as rice farming and plantations and of live trees and other activities. This is a Creole saying, which says, for better farm business, tap for seas advantage per woman. For a good outcome of farming, stop exploiting women.
Maybe initially you do something that seems fairly neutral, like maybe doing a field survey. Then you come across human situations where people are involved in that struggle. You have to take side, you have to decide, you know, you cannot let things happen. For example, you find evidence of corruption, that people have been exploited, then you have to do something. Then you get dragged into a whole social situation which has its own dynamics.
We as a civil society were asked by the authorities to be the cushion between the people and the authorities and to create a dialogue and social participation. And instead of that, the officers, who were ineffective and corrupt, put the blame on us.
Bus accident. We have received about 22 patients. One is in very critical condition. She has a severe head trauma. Two lost their legs, and the other ones have fractures, abrasions, simple things. 22 simultaneous patients. We go into another routine in the hospital, and that's why we set up the triage center in the physiotherapy department. And everything is postponed and focused on this.
So now we'll proceed towards the villages so that we can start our work there. The service we undertake is part of our spiritual discipline. Just as we meditate on the Lord, on the self, we work to serve the Lord in man, God in man.
We proposed to the journalists a partnership that we believed would have helped us move beyond our reciprocal stereotypes. We wanted to get away from both preconceptions, that of trying to convince the public and that of trying to conform to the expected taste of the public.
De por qué se daba la pobreza, de por qué no podíamos estudiar, de por qué teníamos que tener los hijos en condiciones de salubridad terribles, de por qué no teníamos acceso a anticonceptivos. Entonces hay un flash y empiezan a surgir muchas preguntas, preguntas que antes no nos hacíamos. Nosotros creíamos que la vida era así, que sencillamente estábamos diseñadas biológicamente para ser madres. Y cuando vienen todas las preguntas, ¿por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? Entonces surge entre nosotras un lazo.
Abide plan. Now plan I did say so. I mean count none of my auntie and count me. We count me as so for campus me school. So I did with my auntie, and my auntie can't die. And I got possible to pay for my school again. So now I begin now at the cell where I come out school, at the cancel but I short. At the get I don't want one block then say, wait time I reach for say something at school, I go. Wait time I reach for pay for my school fees, at the direct by my butter short, then I go again at school. At the pan and the tea, at the cell half, where I come out school, I can't sell. Well, I come scrap at the same, and that they get half. If you know, guy is if I so come for the year, I eat.
I want to change the situation of women here. And by this center, I can do this because I have a contact with a category. Normally, we don't have it. We can't contact it because they are poor. They don't know anything about their rights. Here by the medical service, for example, when they come, I can help them through that. Do you know about your right? Do you know what you can do? Do you, for example, your hospital, your son, can he come here? I will tell him about, you know, about his right more, you know? So this is very good. We can't change step by step.
Our journey was a common one, but as work proceeded, we found it ever more difficult to lead the journalists away from their assumption of knowing best what the public needs to be told. They were supposed to share the final products with us, but it soon became clear that in order to talk to a multicultural audience, we would need to gather additional stories and viewpoints. This was a pity. It created a professional divide between us journalists and you development workers, which made the team less cohesive. At times, the two groups even experienced frictions. We thought of recording these discussions anyway, because it would have helped us narrate our story and reveal the real issues and challenges of development cooperation.
The project which was initiated in 1992, the basic objective was to reduce the transmission of HIV among the sex workers so that infection may not spread from sex workers' community to general population. So it was extremely important how we can motivate sex workers to engage into safer sex practices with their clients.
Ahí están sacando el certificado judicial. No lo pasaron formalmente. No tenía día, no tenía calma ni de día ni de noche para dormir, tanto con mis hijos. Mataban, bueno, etcétera. Entonces preferí mejor salirme así, dejar todo, pero primero mis hijos y mi persona.
La situación de desplazamiento de las personas es un delito, se considera un delito de lesa humanidad, el cual involucra muchísimos aspectos en los cuales nosotros venimos trabajando. Y particularmente nosotros como entidad tenemos una responsabilidad grande en el tema de atención humanitaria de emergencia de estas personas.
Ahí están sacando el certificado.
Yo tenía, nosotros vivíamos en Saravena, en el pueblo, Saravena. A mí me mataron uno.
Y por eso me vine.
Our project is called theater-based peer education. And we focus more on issues related to sexual reproductive health. The idea of saying the word sexual reproductive health, you know, makes people really want to avoid it, especially in certain areas in Lebanon, and especially in the school settings. So this was the first challenge for us, is that to go into these schools and advocate for sexual reproductive health in a way that they accept it, in a way that they're not shocked, or not, in a way that they don't reject us.
Using the Wiki platform, we then linked stories and testimonials to the online Handbook on Development Cooperation so that we could share the resources on how to design, manage, and evaluate projects. Finally, we weaved together the stories and opinions with our own story, our efforts to inform the public about the Millennium Development Goals.
This entire place was covered by forest, but due to logging and unsustainable mining practices, you can see today a wasteland with no, practically no agricultural use. So these activities, negative activities of human being, has not only degraded the land, but also destroyed habitat of rare and endangered species.
We are all rushing at the tourists. Everybody is fighting, come here, come to me, come to me. Well, some people are profit and some people don't profit. So we think calm and said, well, let's come together. This. So, but now for today, we are very proud because for what we have done, people are coming from outside the world, say, oh, here is paradise. You see, as you see the table and the chairs, we start with three of it, three tables, nine chairs. And now we are boasting about 800 chairs, and something like 500 tables.
الصبي كان مستهتر بالمي وما عم يحس بمسؤوليته فكان حارب كثير من القرى بسبب بس هدره
مشاركة بحملة ترشيد المياه اللي عملناها نحن بالتنسيق معهم مع عدة اجتماعات وحوارات اخروا باتفاق مع عدة مدارس موجودة منهم مدرسة بنات الأجيال للمشاركة بمهرجان
For the first time as a generation of people, we have the necessary resource, capability and technology to address every problem on the planet. Only thing that is missing is inclusive human consciousness. In this field, there is no better expertise anywhere else on the planet than as it is in India. These are technologies we have developed over thousands of years.
These people, they have not contributed to global warming, but they are the first people who are like victim of the effect of global warming. So, and they are taking responsibility. In our countries, we are still doing big conference, you know, to know what to do for global warming. Here, they don't spend time talking, they are just doing.
One of the difficulties, like what I'm doing now, is to keep the boat straight. It doesn't go too much on the right or on the left. But that somehow you can do it. When you see that you go on the wrong side, you take on the right side. But the difficulty of this project was that we didn't really have a professional team in place before we started the project. We had an idea, but then it was a project that was supposed to take professionals from many different fields that were not used to work together. Finally, we got a team where people make an effort, and everybody more or less has found its role and is working. We almost crossed the other side, and now at the end of the project, I can say I have a wonderful team by which I would like to start a project.
My first personal aim, pushing me to do this job, to learn from others. So I like to understand this job as a cooperation, which means that both partners learn from each other. Probably when you are a teenager, you don't really realize what is now at the moment your future and what will be your role in 10, 20 years old.
Y estamos sanando todo eso que pasó, porque eso que pasó nos enfermó y tenemos actitudes o acciones todavía del pasado. Estamos haciendo un duelo, estamos reparando el daño que nos hemos hecho y que nos han hecho. Esta comunidad de paz busca una respuesta pacífica para no seguir en esa venganza, en ese dolor. Nos conectamos con esa felicidad. Vemos cómo se vivía, en qué tiempo, cómo se hacía lo que se llamamos. Entonces buscamos esa respuesta. Cómo practicarla en el tiempo de ahora. ¿En qué tiempo vamos? Lo que hacemos es mirar en dónde va el tiempo real y conectarnos en ese tiempo real.
Yesterday there was a demonstration. Which was carried out by a traditionalist Indian political party, and they were asking the local authorities to arrest me. Now, why did they want to arrest me? Why do they want to arrest me? They feel that the public interest litigation that the Kautilya Society has done in the High Court of Allahabad is wrong, is against the people's wishes. And it's against development. Actually, the public interest litigation that the society started some 7 years back was done on the request of the local authorities and the eminent citizens and NGOs of this city. Because we were in a moment of history, a moment of Banaras's development that required that the beautiful ghats of Banaras were protected.
Protect against what?
Protected against the wrong ideas of development, which associate development with construction and construction of new buildings, rather than building on what exists and developing it to become a resource for the community. Because that's why Banaras exists. It exists because of its religious importance, its cultural importance. We have a lot of international tourists that come here. Something like 25,000 pilgrims come here every day and leave it. But they come here for the ghats, for the ashrams, for the temples. And these need to be protected because they are the source of livelihood of the people.
Five words to summarize this documentary.
One is challenge, because we really took a challenge to go outside of the media stereotypes. One is dialogue, because we found the dialogue within the team as the way to narrate something that is not God's voice or not objective voice. One is travel, because we realized that human research is always a kind of travel. One is poetry, because we found the need of poetry in setting a global agenda. And one is hope, because I found that there's much more good happening in the world than the kind of images that we are having about the world. So it's important, and it's difficult, but it's important to give space to hope, space to celebration, in order as human beings be able a bit to be more happy of what we are.